By the way, just so you know, on the very last slide, there is a QR code. So the takeaways that I'm going to go through, you can just zap the QR code at the end. You don't need to take photos or make notes. So let's get back to this. This is not a talk about Dale Carnegie's book, but I'm going to touch on some of the elements of it. This book is still to this day rated as one of the 20 most influential books ever written. So if you haven't read it, I would say it's probably not a bad read, but it is a little bit dated. There are some very interesting points though. For example, even back in the 1930s, Carnegie knew that only 15% came from cognitive ability. So what does that mean, cognitive ability? Coming from our technical training. So if we take that into the field of wellness, that's often going to be protocols, treatments, knowing symptoms, being able to do what you've got to do to be in the treatment group. But actually only 15% of success is coming from that. If we look at the work of, let's say, Daniel Goleman on emotional intelligence, moving forward into the late 90s and the early 2000s, he quoted exactly the same statistic, that only 15% of success comes from cognitive ability, the rest comes from emotional intelligence. So there's clearly a lot more to success than simply knowing our product or our service. Now, I was asked a couple of days ago, at the beginning of this event, by someone who knew I was speaking, can you summarize that book? What's your elevator pitch? Well, I can summarize it in four words, make people feel important. They are the four key words that I would take away from what Dale Carnegie said, because if we make people feel important, they automatically have a better impression of us. Okay, now that's actually quite nicely linked to what Dr. Daniel Friedland was talking about earlier on today, Maslow's hierarchy, which the very top level was all around the essence of feeling important or getting people to feel as if they were meaningful. So actually it links quite well to Maslow.